Are these comic book keys and classic covers cheap enough to buy? What's going on, everybody? This is your host, Lawrence, over at Mighty Comics and Collectibles. And like always, welcome back to the show. Today is everybody's favorite video. I say it every week. It is the Hot 10 Comics of the Week breakdown, where I take the 10 hottest comics according to the Key Collector app, and I break them down for you guys, letting you know which books I'm buying at which prices and which I'm staying away from. But before we get started in the video, like always, I ask, if you're not a current sub of the channel, do yourself a favor. Hit that sub button, smash the like button for me, and like always, let's get into this week's breakdown. Starting off the list at number 10 this week is a copy of Vengeance of Bane number 1 and the first appearance and origin of Bane. And last week we had a CGC 9.8 selling for $385, up a whopping 32%. Over the average. Past couple of weeks, this book has appeared at number 10. To me, I said it before, I'm not buying this book for 300 plus in a 9.8. I don't see the value. I love the character, but again, for the price point for this modern era book, I don't want to do it. Sneaking back on the list at number 9 this week is a copy of Avengers number 9 and the first appearance and death of Wonder Man, who would later go on to be resurrected. And last week, we had a CGC 6.0, a mid-grade copy of this book selling for $400, up 19% over the average. Then we had a CGC 4.5 sale of only $216, up 2% over the average. So I got to ask you guys out there, who is buying this book right here, right now? We got that Wonder Man announcement, I think a couple of years ago. This book popped a little bit and then came right back down. We finally got the trailer for Wonder Man. I got to be honest, it looks pretty good. I know nothing about the character, but it definitely seems like it may be worth a watch. Am I buying this book right here, right now? Only if I could find it for a screaming deal. But at $200, $400, I'm definitely staying away. Oh baby, at the 8th spot this week is one of my favorite books of all time. It is a copy of Amazing Spider-Man number 50 and the first appearance of the Kingpin, this classic storyline Spider-Man No More and an iconic cover by the great John Romita Sr. I call this book the trifecta, and last week we had a monster sale, a CGC 9.0 selling for $6,000, up 7% over the average. Then we had a CGC 5.0 sale for $840, up 14% over the average. You guys know it's one of my favorite books, so it's always going to be a buy for me. But with that said, if you're a Spider-Man fan, you have to own this book. If you're a classic cover fan, you have to own this book. If you're a John Romita fan, you have to own this book. With that said, if you're not any of those things, you probably want to stay away here at these high prices. But for me, you guys know it, I'm always a buyer. I'm happy to see this book back on the list at number 7. It is a copy of Batman number 251 and this classic cover by the late great Neil Adams. This is also the quintessential comic revitalizing the Joker as a homicidal villain. And last week we had a CGC 8.5 selling for a cool $1,000, up 4% over the average. Then we had a CGC 6.0 sale for only $460, up 2% over the average. This book reminds me of my rule, $500 for great keys, whether they be classic covers or first appearances. To me, I always think they're well worth it. Anything more than that, it's to each his own, really. I'd love to own this book signed by Neil Adams in a super high grade. I just don't want to spend the money. Other than that, if you're a massive Batman fan, it is a must own. I'm giving this one a thumbs up. At the 6th spot, how about a book we have not seen on this list in quite a long time? It is a copy of Captain America number 117 and the first appearance and origin of the Falcon Sam Wilson. And last week we had a CGC 9.0 selling for $975, up 16% over the average. Then we had a CGC 6.0 sale for only $250, up a whopping 18% over the average. Now me, I love this book. It is a Silver Age key, one of the first books I bought when I got back into collecting in around 2017. With that said, I think way back when I paid around a 6.0 for around $100. Now I still think $200 for a 6.0 is not a bad deal, and that's around the grade I'd be willing to spend for this book. I don't want to spend $1,000 on this key. I don't see the value in that. But again, if you can get one for cheap, I'm always a buyer of this book. How about we talk a little Star Wars? At number 5 this week is not Star Wars number 1. It is Star Wars number 42 and the first appearance of Boba Fett, the bounty hunter. Also the first cameo appearance of Emperor Palpatine, known as Dark Sidious. And last week we had a monster sale, a CGC 9.8 selling for $1,020, but only up 1% over the average. Then we had a CGC 8.0 sale selling for only $180, up 13% over the average. Now, normally I tell you, if you're a big Star Wars fan, it is a must-own book, and I would agree with that. But with that said, a nice high-grade copy 8.0 for under $200, hell yes, I'm buying this book if I can get this one at a deal. I'm not spending $1,000 on a 9.8. I don't see the value in that. But hey, under $200, your high-grade copy, I'm all over it. Dropping from the top spot all the way to number 4 this week is a copy of Marvel Superhero Secret Wars number 8 and the origin of the Black Symbiote costume. And last week we had a CGC 9.8 selling for $585, up 17% over the average. Last week I finally gave this book a buy at around $523. You know my motto, $500 or less and a 9.8. With that said, I think $585 is a little bit too much. The good news, there's a million copies of this one out there, especially graded in a 9.8. Get one that has bright, beautiful, orange, pinkish colors. We don't want to settle for a faded copy. With that said, I love this book, 500 and under, in a 9.8, or else just get yourself a raw copy. Oh boy, at the 3 spot this week is what else? It is a copy of Incredible Hulk number 340 and this classic cover by the Todd father, Todd McFarlane. And last week we had a CGC 9.6 selling for $380, up a whopping 7% over the average. I remember a couple of weeks ago, I think this book was in the twos at a 9.6. Then we had a CGC 9.4 sale for $295, up a crazy 20% over the average. I gotta ask you guys, you're still buying this book graded at this point? I tell you guys every week to get yourself a raw copy, see if you can get a deal. I don't want to spend this kind of money on a book that's been printed like crazy. Just like Secret Wars 8, all these Copper Age keys, they can be had for super cheap if you can find them for the raw form, and there are a lot of copies out there. With that said, I'm saying no to this one. Again, get yourself a raw book. I can't see spending this kind of money on this key. Wow, back on the list at number 2. I did not think we'd see this book back on the list so quickly. It is a copy of New Mutants 98 and the first appearance of Deadpool. And last week we had another CGC 9.6, but a newsstand copy selling for $699, up 1% over the average. Then we had another CGC 9.2 newsstand issue sell again for $480, up 15% over the average. You guys know I'm not newsstand buyers. I tell you guys this all the time. We talk about newsstands. But with that said, I do want to own this book. And usually I've seen sales in direct editions going for anywhere from $1,000 to $1,300. I just saw one at Elite Comics 11 going for under $1,000. To me, I still think that's too much money to spend with this book on the decline. I think if we get to around $600-$750, that's really where I want to be. Other than that, right now, I'd probably be staying away. And finally, this week, we have a new number one to the list. It is a copy of Iron Man number 1 and the first ongoing title series featuring Iron Man. This is also the origin of Iron Man. And last week we had a big sale, a CGC 8.5 selling for $1,500, up 2% over the average. Then we had a CGC 7.0 sale for $800, up 3% over the average. But guess what? We have one more sale to report on, a CGC 3.5 selling for $435, up a crazy 19% over the average. You guys know if you watch my channel long enough, you know I love this book. It could have been had for cheap in mid-grade for such a long time. I'm shocked to see a 3.5 for over $400. That is a pretty big sale. With that said, I still want to own this book for around $500 and the best grade you can get. Hope you guys enjoyed this week's list. Again, a lot of great books are on this list. I want to own every one of them, and I give a lot of thumbs up. With that said, it is now time for my best buy of the week, and this is a hard choice between Batman 251, ASM number 50, you have a great Star Wars 42, and of course, Iron Man number 1. But you guys know me, I'm a Spidey guy. I'm going with ASM number 50, the trifecta, one of my favorite books of all time. Still, every time I see this book at a show at my LCS, I want to buy it, and I already have a couple of copies socked away. Hope you guys enjoy the list. This is Lawrence over at Mighty Comics Collectibles saying thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you guys soon.